Well, hey y'all, JM Real Guys Reviews. Well, I'm here today to field strip for you the Ruger SR1911. Let's go ahead and get our magazine out and get the gun cleared. We'll make absolutely sure we're cleared, and we are. So let's go ahead and get it field stripped. Okay, as we get started, let me go over with you just a little bit of anatomy. We have the slide stop pin. We have the slide stop catch in the top of the slide. And then we have our little takedown notch that we'll be dealing with also. In the front, we have our barrel bushing, and we have the recoil spring plug. So let's go ahead and start and see exactly what we're going to do to get this process going. What we're going to do is release the pressure on the recoil spring so that we can get the slide off a little easier. To do that, we're going to push down the recoil spring plug and at the same time turn our barrel bushing clockwise. That will release the pressure on the recoil spring and allow us to get the slide off. Let's see what we've got with that. Now there's a tool you can do this with, but this is really easy enough without it. So see if I can show that in the camera. We're going to push down the little plug. Let me get that so I can push it down. Release it, and we got the pressure released from the recoil spring. We turn the little barrel bushing clockwise as we did so. Now it's easy to get the slide off by doing this. So at this point, we want to line up the little notch in the slide, not the slide catch notch, but this little one back here with the little node on the back of either the takedown lever, if you want to call it that, or the slide stop. So let's line that up. When we get that lined up, then on the right side of the gun, we push this little slide stop pin out. And in doing so, as you can see, we now can get the pin out and we're ready to take the slide off and then proceed on to get the slide disassembled. Okay, next we get our recoil spring and rod out. This is the little locking link. We'll push that back, get the barrel back so that we can get our recoil spring and rod out. Very easily to do that. You see that this is like the Colt. It has the little short recoil spring rod. Now we're ready to get the barrel out. Okay, next we want to get our barrel out. To do so, we're going to turn the barrel bushing now back counterclockwise until we line a little node up that you can see inside there, and then it'll slide right out. That's the little node that's lined up. It's the little locking node, so when it turns, it locks it in place. Barrel bushing's out, and now the barrel will come out. So we'll get the barrel released, locking link forward, and the barrel slides right out. Now we're ready to do whatever we're going to do with the gun, clean it, whatever, and ready to reassemble. Okay, to reassemble, we go in reverse order. So we'll get our barrel back in. We have the little locking link forward. Get the barrel to seat back into place. Then we're going to put our barrel bushing back in. There's the little node that's going to lock it in place. So put a little bushing back in place, and then we can lock it in. Okay, to get the recoil spring and rod back in, you notice these little wings on the recoil spring rod, and they're going to go down. Get our locking link back, put a little recoil spring in, get those wings down. Our barrel's locked in, it's all locked into place and ready to go back on to the frame. Okay, now let's get the slide mounted back to the frame, and I'm going to do this in a manner to show you the steps to make sure you can see how the relationship of this locking link goes with the pin for the lock breech mechanism to work. So the locking link is forward. We hold the recoil spring and rod in place, locking link forward. Slide mounts to the frame. And let's look inside here and we'll be able to see the locking link. That's hard for you to see, but just trust me, I'm going to look and I'm going to see that locking link go into place just like it's supposed to as we mount the slide back to the frame. So let's see where a little locking link is. There it is. Got our locking link in place, and we tuck our little pin, place it right in. So we've got our little slide pin on the opposite side with our slide stop into place. And then we're going to pop the slide stop. Got to get our little node back the way we had it at the beginning. So we've got the node. It's going to go into this takedown notch here, not into the slide catch notch. So into this little notch here, we'll get it lined up in place. It pops in perfectly. All right, get a recoil spring plug back on. It fell off. And we're ready now to put the pressure back on the recoil spring. To do so, we simply go reverse order as taking it out, push this back, and be careful pushing this down. There's a lot of pressure on it. And as you push it down, then we're going to go with a little barrel bushing back into counterclockwise position. Lock this back in place. Now recoil spring plug's locked in. We've got our pressure back on the recoil spring. We are fill stripped and ready to get back out and have some fun. So that's the way you fill strip the Colt 1911. Fill strip's identical to this Ruger SR1911. Thanks y'all for viewing our videos here at Real Guys Reviews. We appreciate it. Hope to see you around.